Shalom, shalom, shalom. Yasha Allah. Shalom. I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakah HaKadosh. Double honors to the elders at GMS who I learned the truth from. You know, I'm not actually in the group, you know, but those are the people that I learned the truth from, the real truth. And I'm giving reverence to them, you know, because I have to give homage where homage is due. And I thank the Lord for introducing me into GMS and the elders. So I thank the Lord for them. So today I'm going to go over, the title is The Importance of a Father's Role. Okay, the importance of a father's role. What inspired me to do this video is, you know, just I had seen this video about this woman, who, you know, these women was out in the parking lot. They was fighting, and while they was fighting, they was jumping this one little girl, and the little girl was getting jumped, and somebody, another woman who was jumping the girl, pulled a pistol out and shot the girl. She was trying to pistol whip the girl, but she ended up shooting her, you know. And this matriarch society, and this matriarch society has did a number on our people, you know. These women in control is very, very detrimental to our society, detrimental to the Israelite man, you know. So it prompted me to make this video, and this was inspired by one of the elders in GMS. So it's called The Importance of a Father's Role. And I want to go to the first scripture, which is Ecclesiasticus chapter 3 and verse 2. And it reads, "For the Lord hath given the father honor over the children, and hath confirmed the authority of the mother over the sons." Okay, so we are lacking that father's honor, that father's role, and that father's position in the families today. Okay, which is a part of the curses as well. You know, the father would leave in Deuteronomy 28, when the father would leave his children, you know. Verse 3, it says, "Whoso honoreth his father make an atonement for his sins." Okay, so we know that we have earthly fathers, and we have a heavenly father as well, you know. So honoring both, you know, will make it the atonement for your sins. Okay, but more so honoring, you know, the father that's in heaven, you know, Yahweh. Okay, verse 4, it says, "And he that honoreth his mother is as one that layeth up treasure." Okay, it says, "Whoso honoreth his father shall have joy of his own children, and when he maketh his prayer, he shall be heard." Okay, verse 6 says, "He that honoreth his father shall have a long life, and he that is obedient unto the Lord shall be comfort to his mother." Okay, it says in verse 7, "He that feareth the Lord will honor his father, and will do service unto his parents as to his masters." Okay, and our master, you know, of course, is in heaven, you know, Yahweh, you know, by Hashem Yahweh Shai. Okay, it says, "Honor thy father and mother, both in word and deed, that a blessing may come upon thee from them." Okay? A blessing may come upon thee from them. Okay? And if you, you know, do those things, you know, you'll get blessed, you know? Okay? And verse 9, it says, for the blessing of the Father establishes the houses of children, but the curse of the mother ruleth out foundations. Okay? It says, glory not in the dishonor of thy father, for thy father's dishonor is no glory unto thee. Okay? It says, for the glory of a man is from the honor of his father, and a mother in dishonor is a reproach to the children. My son, help thy father in his age, and grieve him not as long as he liveth. And if his understanding fail, have patience with him, and despise him not when thou art in thy full strength. Okay? It says, for the glory of the man, of a man is from the honor. No, it says, right, okay, I read that right twice. It says, verse 13, it says, and if his understanding fail, have patience. Okay, I read that already. It says in 14, for the reliving of his father, of thy father, shall not be forgotten. It says, and instead of sin, it shall be added to build thee up. Okay. In the day of thine affliction, it shall be remembered. Thy sins also shall melt away. Okay. As the ice in the fair warm weather. Okay. As ice in the fair warm weather. You know, you honor your father and don't forget your father. You know, the Lord ain't going to forget you, and he going to remember you. Okay. It says, and your sins will be melted away. He that forsaketh his father is a blasphemer. Okay. And he that angereth his mother is cursed of God, of Yahweh, the Most High. It says, my son, go on with thy business in meekness. So shalt thou be beloved of him. This is approved. Verse 18, the greater thou art, the more humble thyself, and thou shalt find favor before the Lord. Okay. And I want to look up this definition of patriarch. You know, I'm going to look up this definition of patriarch. Okay. Let's go to the blue letter and look this up. Okay. Patriarch. It says, late 12th century, patriarch, one of the Old Testament's fathers, progenitor of the Israelites, from Old French patriarch, okay, and directly from late Latin patriarcha, okay, from Greek patriarches, chief or head of a family, okay, from patria, family, clan, from patar, which is father, okay, so they put those two words, patriarch and patar, means father, okay, it means to rule, okay, means to rule, okay. It says, also used as an honorific title of certain bishops of the highest rank in the early church. Okay? So it says, the meaning, the father and ruler of a family. Okay? So that patriarch is the head of the family, man. That's divine order. You know, that's the way the Lord set it up on the earth, because that's the way it's in heaven. You know, as above, so below, you know, like we pray, you know, our Father, which art in heaven, you know, he wanted us to have that same order and divine order, you know, on earth, you know. So I'm going to go to another precept. Okay, it says, A wise son, I'm sorry, Proverbs 13:1. It says, a wise son hears his father's instruction, but a scorner heareth not rebuke. Okay, so a wise son gonna listen to his father, and he gonna listen to his father's instruction. Okay, period. Okay, but a scorner here not rebuke. He ain't gonna hear his father. You know, Proverbs 13:22 says, a good man leadeth an inheritance to his children's children, and the wealth of the sinner is laid up for the just. Okay, so it says right there, you know, a good man leaveth an inheritance to his children's children, you know. And what was our inheritance and our heritage? You know, Israel, Yisra'elah, you know, he was giving us that name. He gave us that name and that inheritance. You know, it was passed down. That word heritage and inheritance is synonymous, you know. So we got a good father, man. His name is Yahweh, you know, and his son is our big brother, you know, which is who we worship, Yahweh Shai. You know, that's why we say Yahweh by Hashem, Yahweh Shai, you know, and that's our father in heaven, you know, and he gave us earthly fathers to reverence, you know, just like him, you know. It says, and we so discombobulated nowadays, you know, we don't even leave our kids nothing, you know. We don't leave our kids nothing. No inheritance, you know what I'm saying? We leave it to the kids to, you know, when our fathers or our mothers pass, you know, we leave it up to the kids, you know, to fend it out. And we're supposed to have that, all that stuff in order, you know. But that's, once again, that's part of the curses, you know. So, you know, a man coming to this truth, man, you know, he got to prepare himself to be a man, to become a man, no matter if he had his father in his life or not, you know. Okay. Okay. I'm going to go to another precept. I'm going to go to Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1. Okay. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1. It says, verse 1, it says, children, obey your parents in the Lord. Okay. For this is right. Okay. Obey your children, obey your parents in the Lord. Okay. That's our earthly fathers and our spiritual fathers that the Lord put here, you know, for us to learn from, you know, like the elders at GMS, you know, those are our fathers, you know, they the ones we learn from and make us to be men, you know, they are the examples as a father should be, you know, they are diligent, you know, they still going out there on the highways and byways, you know, they diligent, and you know, they are an example. And that's what we need to be. You know, we always need to want to look up to our fathers, you know. So those are our spiritual fathers as well, you know. Definitely. It says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and mother, which is the first commandment with promise. Okay. That is a commandment, a part of the Ten Commandments, you know, a part of the law. It says that it may be well with thee, and thou mayest live long on the earth. Verse 4. And ye fathers, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. Okay? And they, like I said, it goes back to our fathers, our spiritual fathers that's here guiding us and giving us the truth. You know? You know what I'm saying? They got to nurture us up, you know, and what you got to feed a baby, you know, you got to feed a baby milk first, you know, until he's old enough to be able to digest that meat. Okay. And right now I'm getting the milk, you know, and I appreciate that, you know, and I'm think I'm going to go to one more scripture. Okay. One more scripture, bear with me. Okay, let's go to Mark 3 and 27. Mark chapter 3, verse 27. Okay. Okay. And this is what pretty much that our enemies, you know what I'm saying, Esau, Edom, they did, you know, to our houses, you know. They understood the structure, you know, and the order came through the man, you know. So what did they do? You know, they pretty much, you know, took the man out of the house and put the woman as the head, you know. Now the woman is the head of the house, you know, but that's a prophecy, you know, saying that I see a new thing on earth. A woman shall surpass a man, you know, roughly paraphrasing, you know. So that's part of the curses as well, too. For our disobedience, you know, our woman is on top of us and leading us, you know, and it's not until we come into this truth where we set our house back in order, you know, and get back in our rightful seat, you know, through wisdom, of course, you know, because we know we still in captivity. So we know that, you know, it's only certain things we can do right now, you know, and it's very hard to be a man in his own household, you know. But you stick to those punches, you know, until Shiloh come, which is Yahweh Shai, and we're going to get back in our rightful seat, you know. And these women going to get in order. Trust me, they're going to get in order, you know. They are going to get in order. So right now, our woman should be the truth, you know. Who can find a virtuous woman? Okay, that's one or twofold, you know. That could be talking about an actual woman, and you can get that woman. That's what you can give your woman to learn. That's all she needs to know is Proverbs 31. Okay, who can find a virtuous woman? She don't need to know nothing else. Okay, and have her learn from that to become a better woman and a better wife for you. Okay, but that's all she needs to know. Okay, and that's another way you can hit it. You know, that woman is Sophia, which is wisdom. Okay, who can find that? And if we do find that, you know, it'll be a pillar of rest to us, you know. It'll be a tower of death. That wisdom, which is Sophia, okay, which is that woman, because Israel is likened unto a woman, okay, that is going to secure us, man, you know. That's going to secure us, you know. So that's what we need to be searching for and finding for that wisdom, you know. Okay, what I say, I was going to go to Mark 3. Okay, so Mark 3, and we start at verse 27. And that's the point. It says, no man can enter into a strong man's house and spoil his goods except he will first bind the strong man, and then he will spoil his house. Okay. So that's what our enemies did to us, man. They bound the strong man physically and spiritually, mentally, you know. They bound the strong man, okay, and spoiled his good, our goods, you know. We don't get no respect in our house no more, you know. I remember when the man used to get the big chicken. Now the women eating the big chicken now. Well, shit, some of these women ain't even cooking at all, okay. So that's what happened, man. They bound the strong man, okay? And we domesticated pretty much, and we dumbed down, okay? But it's not until we come into this truth, you know what I'm saying? Well, that lion come back into us. The spirit of that lion is coming back into us. Who should ride Judah up, right? Okay, Judah gonna be in the hands of his captors when he rise up, okay? So. It says, who should bind, you know, no man can enter into a strong man's house and spoil his goods, except he will first bind the strong man, and then he will spoil his house, okay? So, get back in your rightful order, man. You know what I'm saying? Because it's high time, you know, we wake out of sleep, man, okay? Because the judgments is coming right before us, man. And we in the middle of Pesach, man, which is the Passover, you know. So we got to be diligent about this truth And I'm talking to myself as well. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking to myself first and foremost. You know, we got to be diligent when it comes to this truth, man.
Okay.
It's time to step it up, man. You know, it's really just time to step it up, man, and get back in your rightful order, man. As fathers, man. All right. Well, that's it, Israel. You know what I'm saying? Hopefully, you know what I'm saying, I can, you know, I got some edification from, you know, you brothers, you know what I'm saying, that need to, that are fathers, physical fathers, and our spiritual fathers, you know what I'm saying? I hope I got some edification. And, you know, I hope I got through somebody today, all right? So I just want to say, I want to give all praises to Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh Shai, by Hashem Rakar Kadosh, okay? And, Shalom.